I'll tell you, we'll start from the scratch level, okay? Hope you have your system in your Java. Did you use Java before?
No. Actually, I am doing networking.
Okay. No problem. So what you have to do? First, install the JDK. JDK is a software, okay?
Okay.
Just go in the JDK download 1.8. Okay.
Okay.
Now, we'll go here, and I think in the starting they will ask to do the.
No, I have already installed Java in my laptop.
Okay. Just use 1.8 version for Windows EXE, or if you have a 64-bit, so download this. After downloading, you have to install the JDK. One software is there. Then how to check this Java is there in your system or not? Go in the C drive, program files, and you can see we have a Java folder. So you will get two folders here, JDK and JRE.
Okay. So after downloading it, no?
After downloading, you have to install.
Okay.
Installation, just like the how to install the software, no? You will get exe file, just do the next, it will download, then install, then we have to go in the program file, and then we have a Java folder, and you have to download one more editor that is called Edit Plus. So this is the editor, just for doing the practice purpose we are using this editor. Okay, we are not using the real time. For practice purpose we are using this. If you will go in the Google and just download the Edit Plus free download, okay? You will get this exe file, and again you have to check with your bits. We have a 64-bit only. So we'll download this 64-bit disk JDK, you will get this exe file, okay? And you have to install again. Okay. After installing, then what happened? This pop-up will come. Okay. Just drag it. No need to give here this, okay? Don't click anything, just drag it. Now you have to configure this JDK in your this Edit Plus. We have to set the path of this JDK. We'll go in the tools and we'll go in the prefence. Inside this prefence, you can see we have a user tool. Okay. Inside this user tool, we have a group name. So you can give the any group name if you want. Yeah, you can take it the by default group name. No name, not required. So we will add here add tool. Okay. In the go in the program, you will get like that. Okay. So here you can see I have written here, here you have to fill up all this. You can write anything, but according to first we are doing compilation. So we will write here compile. Okay, I already written here. So compile, and here, from here what you have to do, you have to go in your this. You can see we have a this triple button like arrow. Now if you go here and go in the C drive and program files and go in the Java folder, JDK bin folder, you can see we have a Java C. Okay. Just open that. If you will do like that, you will get like that, this path of this. Okay. Now again what you have to do, you have to go here and you have to select here file path, and again you are go here and select this one. Okay. So like that it will come. This is your compilation configuration. Now we have to do execution configuration. So execution, we have a little bit changes. Just I have written here execution exe. Okay. Now now we will go again and we will go in the C drive. And we have a program file, and again we'll go in the Java folder. Before we were given that java.c, now we have to give you this Java part. You will get like that. So like that. Now here you have to select this one, file, now file name without extension. Before we have select here file name, okay, here for execution we have to select file name without extension, and here you have to select same. Now from here we have to select this, and what you have to do, just you have to apply and okay. I'm going to cancel because I already did this. So this is the configuration of your Edit Plus. So now I'm going to start. Okay. Okay. So now I will tell you everything how to start Java coding. Okay. Now just I'm going to save this file, just make it one folder, and if you are doing the practice, just save it that. Okay, so I'm just I have already folder for Java practice. Let's see. Okay, so how to save this file? Just this is your class name, and this is your class keyword, and this is your class name. So exactly you have to save this by using this class name, and extension is .java. Okay, okay. Now I save this. Okay, so one more thing, actually what I'm going to do here, after installation of JDK and Edit Plus software, then what you have to do, we'll go here engineers. Okay, so how this, you know, I'm going to tell you how this coding, how we are going to start the Java coding. We'll understand each and everything. Okay, so now
okay,
actually what happened here, we will, you know, how this Java coding is start. So first, if you if you want to start any Java application project, first JDK is required, then you have to set the path. You have to, you know, in the real time we are using Eclipse, but here for practice purpose, this is very good for practice purpose. Okay. In the Eclipse, by default, all are there. So we cannot do the practice properly. So now, first JDK is there, then I'm going to start the Java application. So first what happened, you can see we have a .java class. Okay, so I save this file. Okay, this is a class keyword and this is your class name. Now we already know Java is object oriented programming language. Okay, what is the meaning of object oriented programming language? Everything is an object, right? So in the real world, these are all are the objects, same computer, bank, employee, cap, light, fan, shop. So these are the objects. Okay, so object means someone, like I'm going to start one business, you know, online classes business. Okay, so this is my requirement. I want to start my business. Okay, so how to, you know, I have to develop one application, right? Inside this application, many things are there, right? So like in my application, my requirement is, my logical part is, business logic is, someone will do registration. I have a two logic. One business logic is, I want to provide the online live session, and I want to provide the recording session. So this is my two business logic, right? So real world object, how to convert into the programming world? Programming world means we are performing the automation like that. So you can see we have a net banking, e-commerce, Redbus, IRCTC, make my trip. So these are the business, right? These all are having the business logic. If you will go in your any application, take a Redbus or take a Amazon. Okay, this application, you are going for the this application. So in this application, we have a UI part, front end and back end. So UI is your front end, we are able to see, but you can, back end is, many things are there, right? If you will go here, if you are not registered, you are the new users, you have to give the all the information. This is the one business logic. After verify, your data is already in the database in the Amazon. This is another business logic. So Java is object-oriented programming language. Object-oriented programming language means real world object. This real world object we have converted into the programming world. What is meaning of the programming world? We are performing the automation and achieving our business logic. Okay, so why we use this class keyword? This class keyword will convert real world object into the programming world, like Amazon. Okay, like Amazon, like you know, Redverse. Okay, so why we use Java class keyword? So if you are using, when we are using this class keyword, you can write any object. That real world object will convert into the programming world. Okay, so that's why we are writing class keyword, but in the OOP concept we will discuss in the details. Okay, in the OOP concept we will discuss in the details. Okay, so just my intention is why we are writing class keyword. Got it, right? So that's why we are using this class keyword. Class keyword means real world object converting into the programming world. Programming world is nothing but we are performing this automation. Automation, if you will go in this URL, so we have a many logic inside this, right? So they have developed this. So how do they have developed this logic and all? That is the OOP principle. Okay, so we will discuss in the coming session. So we are learning, you know, how to start your Java coding. So now we can see we have a two brackets here, open and curly braces. This field is called class field. Okay, this field is called class field, opening and curly braces. So now what operation I did here? I did only dot java class. This is my file, dot java class. After that, if you will write here anything, you know, so what steps to execute our code, so first dot java class file is have. Now we have to do compilation. Okay, you have to ask the question why we will use this compiler and what is the use of compilation. So in the Java we are doing two things. If you are going to execute Java application, first we will do compilation. What is the meaning? So if you will configure that tool, it is a shortcut. If I will press Control 1, it will compile the code. So what is the job of compiler? Compiler is checking the syntax of the code. Okay, you can see this is the error. It is showing this line number 6, we have an error. So everything will start, end with semicolon. So if I will again execute, you can see now we are getting the different error. Compiler is telling the different error now. Compiler is telling this syntax is not applicable for Java, whatever you have written. So compiler is very intelligent. If you will write anything wrong, which is not a concept of Java, then it will throw error. So what is the job of compiler? Compiler will check the syntax which is available, if anything which is applicable for the Java concept. If it is not a part of Java, then what happens? Compiler will throw error. Okay, so what is the job of compiler? So when you are installing the JDK, then inside this we have this software is already inbuilt in your system. When you will install JDK software, we have a compiler, we have a JRE, we have a JVM. Okay, I will tell you what is the use of three software. Okay, so now what I did here? Here I'm going to perform another operation, compilation, but compiler. So compiler is, showing this error. So again I will go and I will compile. Now we are not getting any error now. So when you compile this code, then what happened? One dot class file will be generated automatically. Who will generate? Compiler will generate. I'll show you that this dot class file, Java, one second. don't agree, yeah. Okay, so here we'll go here. You can see we have a many dot class file. So if I will go in this one dot class file, this is not a class, whatever the class, I'll show you another class one. So if you open this, we will get like that. Okay, so now we will get why the compilation is required. This dot class file is nothing but this is the bytecode or this is the machine code. This code will able to understand JVM. This JVM, because we are interacting with the JVM, right? So we have a Java virtual machine in your system when you are installing this JDK. Okay, so when you are installing the JDK, then JVM is not able to understand our this language. JVM is able to understand dot class file. What is the dot class file? This is the byte code and this is the machine code, and JVM is able to understand this code. Okay, so now second steps we have completed. If you are executing any Java code, this steps is completed. Now we will interact with the JVM, then we will get output, right? We will interact with the JVM, then we will get output. So now we have completed this step. So if I'm going to execute, so we have a shortcut for Control C T R L and 1+1. Okay, Control 1. Okay, it will compile. Okay, after configuring this piece, we have a CTRL2. It will execute our code. Okay, so now I'm going to execute, but you can see I'm getting this error. Okay, so main method not found in your class, please define the main method. Okay, we will learn here more point here. Okay, what point we will learn here? So in class we have a one class. Okay, but here what is the problem is when I'm going to interact with the JVM, then we were getting this error, main method not found. Okay, now one word came here, main method. So main is a method name, and we will understand why main method is required for execute for our Java class, right? We have to understand. So this class level, if you are writing anything, I am writing here system.out.println. Okay, hello. Okay, so here this system is a class, inbuilt class, and out is a variable and println is a method. This is the inbuilt, okay, which is developed by the Java people. This is the inbuilt print statement developed by the Java people. If someone will ask what is the system, system is an inbuilt class, out is a variable, and println is a method. And this is going to print here. When we are writing this anything, like if you want to print anything as a class level. Class level means curly braces here, open and close here. Field is called class field. Now if I will compile this code, then you can see again I'm getting this error. From compilation we are getting this error, and this error is telling illegal startup type. But my question is why we are getting this error. So one conclusion is, as a class level you cannot write a logic. This is the logic developed by the Java people. Okay, system.out.println is a logic. So logic you cannot write that directly. I told you, right, this business logic. Might be you have to develop one logic to registration page. Okay. Okay, so registration page you have to write the logic. So here this is the business operation, registration page. Registration page logic. Okay, one is your online payment logic. Okay, these are the logic. Okay, another logic is the like checkout process. These are the business logic. Okay, if the developer cannot write the logic as a class level, then how to write the logic? Okay, so okay. Java people have given the concept called method. Okay, so we will not understand now what is, you know, method and all. Just I want to tell you in this session, as a class level, we cannot write the logic. This is called user defined method. We will not understand what is this all. Just you have to understand this is called user defined method. User defined method means the we have developed this method, right? Users. So before you can see this SOPLN is a logic. Like this is your registration page logic. This is the dummy I'm going to print here. This registration page logic, if you will write as a class level, then what happened? We were getting this error. Okay, you can see we have a illegal state type. Okay, we cannot write this logic as a class level. Why it is a class level? Opening and curly braces is here. So this is your class level. So this logic cannot write directly as a class level. Okay, so where we can write this logic? Where you can write this logic? When we are writing this at class level, we were getting this. So this logic we have to write inside this method. Okay. So now we have a what point we have learned today? How to start your Java coding? Okay. Mm-hmm. What is the class keyword? What is the? This is your class keyword means. Class keyword means real world object we are going to convert into the programming world. So this opening and closing braces from here, not this one, from here, this is called class field. So if you have a class field, we can, after that we have to do compilation. Compiler will check the syntax of the code. If anything mistake is there which is not applicable for the Java concept, then compiler will throw error. And what we have learned, if you are writing as a logic as a class level, then we are getting this compile time error. So as a class level, we cannot create a logic. Okay, so how to create a logic? When I compile this code, so without main method, we can compile this code. But I'm going to try to execute this code, that JVM is asking where is your main method. Main method means we have a method. Method first we will understand method, then we will come with main method. Okay, so why method is required? Because the logic, we cannot write the logic as a class level directly. So this is my user defined class, sorry, user defined method. I will tell you coming session method is a separate topic. So we have this non accessibility modifier. Okay, this is return type, so I will tell you later. Just you have to understand this block is called method block. Inside this method block we have written this logic. Before we were getting this compile time error, now I am not getting compile time error. You can see, because the logic I have written inside this method class level, we were getting this compile time error, right? But now we are not getting any compile time error. But if you will try to execute again, JVM is still asking where is your main method. One question we have to understand here, why main method is required to execute your Java application? If you don't have a main method, then you cannot execute your Java application. Got it, right? If you don't have a main method, you cannot execute your Java application. You have to ask the question why main method is required. Okay. So now we are stuck here. When I'm trying to interact with a Java virtual machine, so here the JVM is asking again where is your main method. Okay. So first we understood why method is required. We cannot write the logic, you know, as a class name. So we can write the logic as a inside this method. Now we will understand many developer is there, right? So some developer is created here another method. Okay, this is the non-static method. So here they have written the logic for this. Okay, so actually the JVM developer who had developed the JVM developer doesn't know which logic and which method you are going to create. Okay, which method you are going to create. So how to interact with the JVM? Okay, so JVM is confused, right? JVM is a software, then JVM doesn't know which type of the method you are going to create. So that's why the JVM developer develop the common method that is called main method. If you will execute your code, then what happen? Your execution will start from main method. I think you got idea about why main method.
Yes, sir. Yes, yes.
Right? So main JVM software having the main method, which is common. If you are executing any Java application, then it will search main method. This main method is there or not. So control will come here and find with this method. Then if you are writing any logic here, it will execute. Okay, and method is executing from top to bottom in the sequential, top to bottom. Okay, it will execute like top to bottom. So now this is your main method. If I just want to print this main. Now if I will compile this, okay, this is whatever is coming. I think some block, I missed this. It's already defined. Oh, okay. So what happened? What the error is? This M1 is already defined. So just we are going to change this M2. Okay. So now I am able to compile this code. I am able to execute this code. But you can see only we are getting this main. You know why? Because this is user defined method. Okay. So when you are creating any user defined method, we have to call this method. But main method is automatically called by the JVM. Okay, so I will teach you what is this public, static, void and main in the coming session. So this just my agenda is how to start your Java. How to start your Java code, and you know how and when you are writing anything, then what is the use of this. Okay, so user defined method, how to execute this. This is the static method. So static method will call directly by using this name. Okay, so coming session we will discuss all the things step by step, like method. Okay, so we have to, if you are using user defined method, you have to call this method. So now I call, you can see where I call this method, inside this main method. Why? Because the if you will execute, then it will search JVM. Okay, JVM will search main method. So main method is executed, then this line is executed, this M1. So this is a static method, you can call directly. Okay, I will tell you in the coming session all the things. Okay. So it will go and execute this method. This is non-static method. If you will call this non-static method directly, here you will get error. Okay, you can see what the error we are again getting here. Non-static method cannot be referenced from a static context. So I will give you little bit idea about of a static and non-static. Okay, so I will give you little bit idea about of a static and non-static. Okay, so we are using this keyword, right? A static and non-static. So this is, you know, non-static method, but I call this non-static method and we are getting this error. So why a static and non-static is, you know, what is the static and non-static, we will understand. Okay, so we have a one application. This is your banking application. in this banking application we have a bank name, class, bank. Okay, just leave it. Just I took this variable, a string. Here I am writing a static. Why I am writing a static, I will tell you. A string, bank name. Bank name. Okay, bank name I took here. Okay, so we have a, I'm going to take in the string format only. So we have to a static IFSC code. Okay. So now I am going to take customer name. Okay, customer name. Now when we are using a static means which is common for all, so when we are writing this bank name, so bank name is common for all the customer, right? IFSC yes. code is common for all the customer, right? So yes. if you have a static, then we have a single copy of memory. Like you have written here a static bank, so here only one copy of memory is created here for a static, one copy. This IFSC code is only one copy of memory is created inside this JVM. But we have a multiple customer, then what happens if I will write the also a static for one customer? Then this is the static for the common memory for the all the customer, right? So what happened, this is the customer, one customer information is their name. Okay, we have a mobile number and we have a PAN card number. So these are the customer. Okay, the problem is that if you have a single copy of memory for all the customer, if some mobile number is changed for the one customer, then what happened, this will affect to the all the customer, right? Customer data, because this is the single memory of for all the customer. So what is the, this is the problem for static. Then we will consider non-static. So non-static means we have a multiple copy of memory. A multiple copy of memory, so every customer having the a specific copy of memory. I think you got some idea about a static and non-static, where we will use in the real time. I will not use, because this bank name is common for all the customer, IFSC is common for all the customer, that's why I use what, a static. But bank customer information we will take non-static. Okay, this is the one thing. Now we will come with memory, how this memory is getting. So a static, when you are writing this a static keyword, then when class is loaded into the JVM, then JVM is provided a static member memory. Okay, so that's why I call directly this M1, but if you will, you can now M1 I call, because we have already memory. Okay, but if you will call M2, you can call M2, you can see we are getting some error, non-static method cannot be referenced from the static context. Okay, so what happened, non-static member will not get memory directly, we have to create a object. I will tell you this, I will give you the how to create an object. So how to create an object, so we have a new keyword, so when you are writing new keyword, one object is created. Okay, inside this object, this, and this is, just consider this is the object I created here, this M1 method got get memory, this is your M1 method is there, you got memory M1 method. okay, M1 method get memory. Inside this is new keyword means object is created, and this is called constructor. So coming session we will discuss regarding this. Just I have created, this is the constructor. Constructor means class name and constructor name is same. So why we are using this constructor? To initialize this object.
Okay
class. Okay, so this okay. Object is initialized, and this is your referenced variable. Why we are using this referenced variable? To accessing this, you know, object. Inside this we have to access. How to access? Then we will use t.m1. okay, so whatever the member which is available in the object, we are going to access by using this referenced variable. Okay, so now this, that's why we are using this reference variable. And this is your type. Which type it is? Class type. Okay, so which type it is? Demo test type.
Okay.
So this is class. When you are writing this class, I'm not writing here. When you are writing this class, so what happened? When you are writing this class, class is also the type. Which type? Object type. Which object? Bank object. Bank. So this is the which type? Bank type. Okay. This is, if you are using this class, a student. JVML student, which type? A student type. If you are using class employee, which type? Employee type.
Employee
right?
Type.
Like okay. That. If you are using int a equal to 10, which type? Int type. Okay. Double. Which type? Double d equal to double type. So like that, class is also what indicate the type. So it will tell the type, which type it is. Demo test type. I think you got some idea out of this line of the code. And now
yes.
I'm going to access this non-static. Now I'm able to complete, you know, how to start your Java code. So I have given some documentation regarding this Java stuff. So where it is, we'll go in this. So we have a basic Java. So why Java? Java programming language mainly designed to develop the internet application, means web application, providing the platform dependency. Dependency means I have developed one application in the window, but okay. Client requirement is they want to also execute in the Linux, Mac,
yes. All the operating system.
Yes, all the operating system. So this is your platform independency. C and C++ language support developing only a standalone application. It can only be executed in the current system, cannot be executed in the remote system in via network call. Okay, so a standalone means this is not part is your standalone application, only one user is able to use. An internet application means, you know, Facebook, millions of the users are using. Google, right? So millions of the users are using. Type of the application, we have a standalone application, we have a internet application. So both same, and application that can be executed in the local system, which is called a standalone application. Internet application means web application, application that can be executed in the local with local calls and from the remote computer via the network request. This is called your internet application. Definition of Java. Java is a very simple, high level, secured. Secured is very important because the Java having the more security as compared to another language, even Python also. So all the secured application develop on the Java. Platform independent, object oriented programming language. This word is very important. This is the object oriented programming language. It is developed by the James Gosling in Sun Microsystems in 1990 for the developing the internet application. Its first version is released in January 2000, 1996. We have a Java features. So it is a simple, object oriented, secure, robust, portable, high performance and dynamic. Who developed the Java? James Gosling. So not required this all the things. So So Java tech terminology used in the programming language. So source code. This code I have developed. I did not compile. I did not execute. That code is called source code. Okay, compile code. You know, we did compilation. Generate the program that convert into the source code into the compile code. Compile code means byte code. Means machine code. So compiler translate program that convert source code into the machine language at once. Interpreter, what is the interpreter will doing the line by line, but it will execute at once. This is the difference between the compiler or interpreter. Executable code means OS understand, you know, rapidly execute, means exe file. Okay, but we don't have a exe file in the Java. Compilation means it is a process to translate the source code into the compiled code. Execution means it is a process to running compiled code into the output. So Java technology. So Java technology in the both platform and programming language. Platform is a hardware software environment in Java program are executed. Java had its own software developed. It's called a JVM, means Java Virtual Machine, to execute Java program. Like C and C++, Java program are not directly executed in your OS. In C and C++, you can execute your code directly, but for Java, you have a required JVM, means you have to install the JDK. What is the platform? So platform means hardware and software. Okay, and what is the platform dependent and independent? So we already know platform dependent means if you develop the application in window, it will run only in the window. Independent means you can run in the any flavor of the OS. Just I have written this documentation, read once, okay, later. What is the Java file extension? So we have seen .java class, we have seen .java, .java class, right? So I already discussed this, right? The .java extension file is called source code, which is developed by the developer. This code means called compiled code, contain the byte code, which is generated by the compiler from the source code. Like C and C++, Java won't have an executable code. So we already discussed this thing, okay? So
yes,
Java program developing compilation and execution procedure. This one, okay? That one I have given this, all that documented this, okay? So developing compilation and execution. In Java programming language, all the source code first written in the plain text file. So what the plain text file I have used here, editor, edit plus editor, okay? So now ending with .java extension, and those source file are called compiled code. What is meaning of compiled code? Means .class file, all the things we had already discussed, right? File does not contain code, that means native your processor. So this is called also native language, this bytecode. Why? Because this Java virtual machine is able to understand. Okay, so now I'm going to stop your session. So till now I will send you this, all this notes also, okay, in your mail.
One more thing, actually I want to know what are the topic required to for testing.